Hello friends, how you doing today? Welcome back to our brand new episode, as we're back with some latest space updates. We'll start with the static fire test of Super Heavy, followed by a new Crew Dragon contract from NASA to SpaceX, and we'll wrap up with an update on the Artemis 1 mission. Let's get started with SpaceX's Super Heavy booster test, as well as new updates on Starship height. Recently, in the midst of preparations for orbital launch in the future, SpaceX teams have carried out a multiple-engine static fire test on Super Heavy Booster 7, or popularly called B7. According to reports, this was the first time ever that the booster had fired up more than one of its Raptor engines. It's estimated that with this first multiple-engine test, the static fire test procedure will continue to take up a further number of engines for test and will finally reach the stage of firing all 33 Raptor engines of Booster 7. Once that happens, it will become a record-breaking event in both SpaceX's and overall rocket development history. As per sources, on the 31st of August 2022, at 2:03 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, SpaceX teams ignited 3 Raptor engines on Booster 7 for the test, and the test lasted for 5 seconds. Some sources state that during the 31st of August booster test, only 2 Raptor engines may have fully lit up, with the possibility of the third engine aborting the test. In the first half of August, SpaceX had carried out 2 static fires of Booster 7 at the orbital launch site in Texas Starbase. But those tests involved just one of the vehicle's Raptor engines. Earlier, in the case of the Starship upper stage, Ship 24 had carried out a static test in a similar way, eventually igniting 2 of its 6 Raptors in the first week of August. While preparations for Starship orbital launch are going on, Elon Musk has shared an important update regarding Starship's height. According to Musk, the rocket's height will rise by 5 to 10 meters when the company increases its production further. Musk wrote on Twitter that it will grow by at least 5 to 10 meters over time. This comment from Musk had come up as a reply to a tweet that showed a picture comparing the major rockets of the world with a tag, "The scale of the Starship is insane." In our next update, SpaceX receives a $1.4 billion award from NASA for 5 more Crew Dragon launch contracts. Recently, SpaceX has received 5 more Crew Dragon launch contracts from NASA. These new launch contracts will help NASA to secure their astronaut access to the International Space Station until 2030. As per sources, the award comes nearly 3 months after NASA had released a notice of planning to buy 5 additional missions from SpaceX. 3 months back, the space agency had signed a contract for launching 3 more Crew Dragon launches. Now, keeping into account the recent Dragon Launch Contract 2, SpaceX has received almost 8 new Crew Dragon launch contracts from NASA in the past 6 months. NASA stated, "SpaceX's crew transportation system is the only one certified to meet NASA's safety requirements to transport crew to the space station and to maintain the agency's obligation to its international partners in the needed time frame." On the 31st of August, NASA stated in an official update that the deal with SpaceX allows NASA to maintain an uninterrupted U.S. capability for human access to the space station until 2030. SpaceX tweeted after receiving the award that NASA has selected Dragon for 5 additional commercial crew missions to and from the space station, which brings the total number of astronaut Dragon flights for NASA up to 14. According to some reports, the recent Crew Dragon launch contract adds missions for Crew 10 to Crew 14. Thus, with addition of these missions, the total number of planned operational NASA astronaut launches comes up to 14. According to NASA, the 5 extra Crew Dragon missions will cost almost $1.44 billion, and the overall Commercial Crew Transportation Capabilities, or CCTCAP, contract will raise to the total of $4.93 billion. As per reports, taking into account The earlier $2.74 billion that SpaceX received from NASA for funding development and three test launches, NASA will eventually pay an average of $328 million for each of the 15 Crew Dragon astronaut launches, and also included Demo 2 mission. According to some estimates, if the number of astronauts remains fixed on 4 for each operational launch, then the average launch price per astronaut till 2030 will be nearly $85 million. But with the latest contract in hand, NASA will get some further benefits. In the latest contract set, NASA will pay $288 million per launch, or $72 million per astronaut, fairly beating the earlier amount. Also, this decision of NASA to award SpaceX 8 new Crew Dragon launch contracts in 2022 is a major blow to their second commercial crew provider, Boeing, which has received 0 additional orders and is continuously lagging behind. Today, we'll wrap up with the upcoming next launch attempt of the Artemis 1 mission. On the 29th of August, NASA had attempted launch of the Artemis 1 mission, but the launch was aborted due to problems in the temperature sensor of the Space Launch System, or SLS, rocket. And on the 30th of August, NASA officials stated in a press conference that they'll go on for a second launch attempt of SLS on the 3rd of September at 2:17 p.m. Eastern Time. As per reports, the duration of the launch window will be 2 hours. This new launch date is a day after the planned second launch attempt date. NASA officials have explained why they delayed the attempt by a day. SLS have developed a hydrogen leak in the tail service, mast umbilical, though the issue has been resolved before the first scrubbed launch attempt. Yet, the engineers want to inspect the problem further. NASA Artemis Launch Director Charlie Blackwell Thompson said, "We want to do some inspections and want to do some retorques." Regarding the recent launch date, Mark Berger, Launch Weather Officer for the U.S. Space Force's Space Launch Delta 45, said that though the possibility of harsh weather is somewhere in the neighborhood of 60%, "I still think we have a pretty good opportunity, weather-wise, to launch on Saturday." During the last launch attempt, launch controllers faced problems with the kickstart bleed system. According to reports, one of the 4 engines, designated engine number 3, failed to get into the same temperature as the other 3 RS-25 engines. All the correcting measures had 2 failed then, and it led to launch scrub. John Honeycutt, NASA SLS program manager, stated that the hydrogen bleed is designed to cool the engines to about 250 degrees Celsius. Engines 1, 2, and 4 got down to about 245 degrees Celsius, but engine number 3 was only at about 230 degrees Celsius. Honeycutt said that the temperature difference may have happened due to faulty sensors in the engine rather than the flow of liquid hydrogen into the engine. He said, "We're a little bit concerned about one of those sensors because they're seeing good, cold liquid hydrogen being vented out of the engine. We understand the physics about hydrogen performs. The way the sensor is behaving doesn't line up with the physics of the situation," Honeycutt added. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.